998, 999, 1,000. Ugh, see a vein almost. Could kind of say things are getting pretty serious. The No Fade Channel checking in, and today I'm going to be reviewing this obscure weight bench set, whatever you want to call it, on this episode of Dad's Home Gym. If this is your first time to the channel, hit that subscribe button. On this Dad's Home Gym series, I typically review a piece of home gym equipment on every episode to help you decide if it's right for your home gym, if it's gonna meet your expectations, or better yet, exceed your expectations, and if it's worth your hard-earned money. Today, I'm gonna be going over this budget, this cheap, super cheap budget, obscure bench set. We're gonna go over the pros, and there are some pros, believe it or not. We're gonna go over the cons. Then we are gonna test the 300-pound weight capacity this thing supposedly has. And we are gonna put every plate I own on this thing to see if it absolutely collapses in my home gym. Now, this obscure weight bench assembly is nothing you're gonna find at roguefitness.com, but it does have a few pros. So let's get into them. Number one, it's cheap. I didn't say low cost, I said cheap. It is $124 shipped, delivered anywhere in the United States. And basically on today's cost, you're not gonna find anything cheaper than this. As far as what it comes with, you've got your flat bench. It goes from flat all the way up to 90 degrees. It can do more than just hold your son's hard helmet. It also can hold a straight bar here. Keep in mind that these will go up and down a little bit. There's a little bit of variance in terms of how high you can get these. Not much. As far as what bar it will hold, it's really meant for those 1-inch bars that you probably have like as a kid or really beginner set. It could hold like the bar you see behind me, which is your typical Olympic style bar, your typical everyday type of bar you would find at a local gym. But even though you could put that on here, it only does have a 300-pound weight limit. And we're going to get into that afterwards. Also, it actually has in the back, hopefully you can see back here, dip handles. So if you wanted to do dips, you could. And the last, probably the last pro I can probably mention with regards to this thing is the fact that it has the ability to stand up straight to conserve space. So let me hopefully show you here. All right, I know so many of you have super tight space, and if that's the case, this might be right for you, but probably not. I'm gonna go over the cons on this thing, but the purpose of today's video, besides testing that 300-pound weight limit by putting every plate I possibly own on top of this thing, is to really help you get in the right mindset that you don't have to spend a lot of money, but when you do go budget, you really wanna be smart about it for two reasons. Number one, you might end up with something like this. And number two, you can go budget and have a very effective home gym on a budget. And if you do it in the right way, you're at a good spot to transition to your next step on your home gym, whenever that time comes. Whenever you want to upgrade or improve on your home gym, even though you went budget, it doesn't mean you have to start over. You can then move on, okay? And that's what I wanna talk about mostly in today's video. So let's get into some of the cons. Number one, this thing is super light and it is only got a 300-pound maximum weight limit. Even assuming that it holds 400 pounds, that's not that much. I'm 185 pounds, and if you figure I put like 90 pounds in my hand, I'm already over, 90-pound dumbbells in my hand, I'm already over the weight limit on this thing. A few more cons before I dive into what I would do with that $124 is that this bench is super short. You can probably tell the front pad does not lift up. So even though this inclines, this is going to stay flat and you are going to slide off the front end of this thing if you were able to manage to get a bunch of weight on here and not have the whole thing collapse on you. Also, where the bar handles are is a really awkward position. I did try to bench on this thing just for giggles. And your hands are, it's basically, this is right where you're gonna wanna put your hands on the bar, really close to it. So it's just really hard to bench on here if you did wanna risk your life and try that as well. So what could you do with that $124 if you did wanna go budget? And I have no complaints about people going budget. I know there's tons of people out there getting a great job on a budget home gym, but this one obviously just isn't it. And I cannot wait to see if this thing collapses with all the weight I'm gonna put on it. But A couple things you could do if you wanted to go budget is to separate these two pieces. So if you wanted to have something that you could bench with and you could use as an adjustable bench, is to buy two separate pieces. I already did a whole video on squat stands that you can pick up now for $75 new on Amazon. I saw one yesterday, $75 new. You can pick up a set of squat stands that's twice as thick and durable as this thing is, and they're movable, so you can move them in and out of any tight spot or location, and you can adjust their width in order to best set up your home bench. Boom, you're already at $75. If you go on Facebook Marketplace, you could probably pick them up for $50. Now, if you wanted an incline bench, I know that Titan Fitness is still selling their incline bench for like $124 with free shipping, and that is by no means the best bench out there that is for incline and for flat and for 90 degrees, but for $124, it's going to get the job done. It's going to be a lot better than this, a lot more durable, and because these are going to be two separate pieces, it means you can transition a lot easier, because if you wanted to get a better bench, that means you can easily just sell your bench, pick up a new bench. Also, in terms of space, if you got a bench and you got a separate squat stand that was two separate pieces, you can move those around to take up very minimal space when they are not in use. Obviously, not as little space as this rinky-dink contraption here when it's up against the wall, but fairly close to it. Now, could you use this to get a workout in? And I'm going to be honest with you. We know there are people that are absolutely getting workouts in with less. So yeah, you could use it if you had to, if you were in a pinch. I don't know if I would necessarily trust it, and we're gonna test that theory. I would say that even though this looks like it's probably meant for a kid, if your kid reaches out to you and says, hey, for Christmas, I wanna get some home gym gear, I would still say shy away from this thing. Even though it would probably do fine for them, you can do better with the same amount of money, or even just a little bit more, you could probably do better. And if you're searching Facebook Marketplace, you can absolutely do better than this contraption. And if you're tight on space, you can still do better than this contraption overall. And the reason I'm really making today's video, this was sent to me to review. And I don't think the people realize that I do honest reviews, because they just sent it to me. And the truth is, people get scammed by this kind of stuff all the time. If you look at the marketing photos on Amazon, they were clearly cut and pasted. They were clearly like edited in a way to make this look bigger than it is, to make it look stronger than it is, and to basically lie to anyone that's on a budget, that's in a tough spot, trying to get something maybe for their friend or their kid or for themselves, and they just don't have the money. And it's a real shame, because I think with a little bit of due diligence, with a little bit of research, you can get a great home gym setup that will do whatever this does for the same amount of money, or maybe just a few bucks more. And now it's time to test if this thing can hold 300 pounds. And the reason I want to test this thing to see if it breaks is because in their photos on Amazon, they put a rhino on top of this thing and said that it would hold a rhino if a rhino weighed 300 pounds. So clearly some smoke and mirrors going on, and we're going to see just how steady this thing is. So these plates are from weightedout.us, huge fan of theirs, US made company, US made steel, US everything. They're super thin, but they're 100% accurate and super heavy. I got a few more plates we're gonna throw on here, add up the total, and give you my final thoughts. I gotta be honest, I didn't think it was actually gonna hold this much weight. 507.5 5 pounds with these change plates added on. Obviously, stability-wise, I'm a little nervous that if I push down on one side a little too much, this thing would just go right over. So obviously, the bench itself can't hold that weight more than the 300 pounds it claims. The question then becomes, if you had all this weight on the bar, would these shear pins just snap off? I think that the bench would hold like 200 or 300 pounds on here safely. They probably put that 300 mark on there just to kind of cover themselves, because frankly, the bench itself doesn't have much connection to the floor in terms of it's super loose, super shaky, and there's no grip on the pads that they use to hold onto the floor on this thing. I'm gonna go and put all this stuff away now, but hopefully today's video helped you realize a home gym budget build is something that you can absolutely do and you can get great workouts with, but you want to stay away from the junk that is out there. Amazon, Google is littered with so much home gym junk. Stay away from it like the plague. Just do your research, do some due diligence, and don't be afraid of Facebook Marketplace. They have some really great deals there, and I'm going to actually get further down that rabbit hole in another video. If you came in today's video, please do me a favor, give this video a like, hit the subscribe button. Check out my affiliate links in the description of today's video. It does help the channel because that's how we basically pay for the lights, the cameras, and my time. So rock the links if you are interested. Otherwise, just have a great day. Thank you for watching, and don't save anything for the trip back. This channel is dedicated to my life as a father of two wonderful children, and it centers around health, fitness, and all of the tricks and tribulations that I go through to try to be a great parent to my children and still accomplish my own personal goals.